gathered here to bless this inland sea on it. This project I completed. Let us thank the Lord, because God is the center of our life. Without Him, we cannot succeed in our life. Even these inland builders have trusted in His providence of God. So their project has been completed. Let us thank the Lord for all the blessings that God has showered on these builders. And through their efforts, many more residential apartments have come across in this area in Mangalore and other parts of our Karnataka. Let us thank the Lord for their presence amidst us, for their encouragement and all the development they are doing in the city of Mangalore. Before we begin this prayer service, let us praise the Lord of Almighty for showering His richest blessings on each and every one of us. Let us simply begin praising. Praising in the morning, praising in the noontime, praising when the sun goes down, praising in the morning, praising in the noontime, praising when the sun goes down. Let us begin this short prayer service. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us listen to the word of God. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. When the disciples drew near to the village to which they were going, Jesus made as if to go on, but they pressed Him to stay with them, saying, "It is nearly evening, and the day is almost over." So He went in to stay with them. Now while He was with them at table, He took the bread and said the blessing. Then He broke it and handed it to them, and their eyes were opened and they recognized Him. But He had vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, "Did not our hearts burn within us as He talked to us on the road and explained the scriptures to us?" Gospel of the Lord, praise to God, Jesus Christ. My dear brothers and sisters, as we have heard some episode from the life of Jesus Christ, where after His resurrection, He met His disciples on the way to Emmaus, where they lost all their hopes, because after Jesus was crucified, they thought everything was finished. But when they met on the way to Emmaus, Jesus strengthens them. Jesus recalls all the things that He has told to them, and they believe in Him, in His presence. So, as God is the center of our life, in the Psalm 127 we say, anybody builds without God, he builds in vain. We need God's grace and providence in our daily life to sustain our spiritual life. We need God in our life. So let us thank the Lord. Wherever we are, whatever religion we belong to, let us hold on to our principles that God has bestowed on each and every one of us. Let's recite the psalm. Your response: happy are those who fear the Lord. Happy are those who fear the Lord. How blessed is anyone who fears the Lord, who delights in His commandments. His descendants shall be powerful on earth. The race of the honest shall receive blessings. Your response: happy are those who fear the Lord. Riches and wealth for His family. His uprightness stands firm forever. For the honest He shines as a lamp in the dark. Generous, tender hearted and upright. Your response: happy are those who fear the Lord. All goes well for one who lends generously, who is honest in all his dealings. For all time to come he will not stumble. For all time to come the upright will be remembered. Your response: happy are those who fear the Lord. To the needy He gives without stint. His uprightness stands strong forever. His reputation is founded on strength. your response. Happy are those who fear the Lord. Let us place before our intentions before the Lord. Our response, God hear our prayer.
God hear our prayer.
The Son of God, Lord of heaven and earth, made his home among us. With thankfulness and gladness, let us call upon him, saying, Lord, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, by your life with Mary and Joseph, you sanctified the life of the world. Dwell within us in this residential apartment, so that all those who stay in this apartment will be blessed. And they have a happy stay over here. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. In you, every dwelling grows into a holy temple. Grant that those who live in this apartment build up together into the dwelling place of God in the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. You taught your followers to build their houses upon solid rock. Grant that the members of this family may hold fast to your teachings and free of all discord, serve you with their whole heart. Let us pray to the Lord. You had no place to lay your head, but in uncomplaining poverty you accepted the hospitality of your friends. Grant that through our help, people who are homeless may obtain decent housing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. Let us pray the prayer taught by Jesus. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Let us pray a prayer before we start our blessing. Let us pray. Lord, be close to your servants who move into this apartment today and the days to come. We ask your blessing. Be their shelter when they are at home, their companion when they are away, and their welcome guest when they return. And at last receive them into the dwelling place you have prepared for them in your Father's house, where you live forever and ever. When we sprinkle the holy water, there shall be showers of blessing. This is the promise of God. There shall be seasons refreshing, and from the Savior above, showers of blessing. Showers of blessing. This is the promise of love. There shall be seasons refreshing, sent from the Savior above. Showers of blessing. We are in the presence of the Lord to pray for this wonderful project the God has completed through the instrument of inland builders. And their contribution to the society, as we are praying for all those residents, those who occupy the flats today, tomorrow and the days to come. May the good Lord bless them, everyone, and especially these inland builders and their efforts and their ongoing projects that they are going to do. May the good Lord complete all those projects that they are undertaking, and bless all the residents, those who are going to occupy the new flats in due time. Bless their stay in this apartment, and may the good Lord bless them abundantly, give them good health of mind and body, and fulfill their heart's desires. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Oh, give thanks to the Lord for His good. Oh, give thanks to the Lord for His good. Oh, give thanks to the Lord for His good. Yes, eternally is His love. I will sing to my God never ceasing. All my life I will tell of His wonder. He is the maker of all earth and heaven, of the ocean, the seas and all they hold. Oh, give thanks to the Lord for His good. Oh, give thanks to the Lord for His good. Oh, give thanks to the Lord for His good. Yes, eternally is His love. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. All the best, everyone of you.